So you had here Maher reported income from continuing operations before taxes during 2020 of $790,000. Additional transactions occurring in 2020 but not considered in the 790 are as follows. So the corporation experienced an uninsured flood loss, bought a machine, there was an error on the depreciation, sale of securities at a loss of $57,000. When the president died, corporation realized $150,000 from the insurance policy, being carried on the books as an investment in the amount of $46,000. Corporation disposed of its recreational division at a loss of $115,000 before taxes. And then the corporation decided to change its method of inventory from average cost to FIFO. So the first thing it's asking us to do is to prepare an income statement, starting with income from continuing operations before taxes, compute earnings per share, and then it gives us the common shares outstanding. Okay, so what we're going to do is basically our beginning number here, unadjusted. Basically right over here, under continuing operations before taxes was 790,000. Okay, so that's where we're starting. So the uninsured flood loss, okay, that is gonna be an other income or expense. So uninsured flood loss, this is gonna be an adjustment here of 90,000. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this beginning number and see what I need to go through and adjust. Number two, at the beginning of 2018, the corporation purchased a machine for $54,000 with a salvage of nine that had a useful life of 6 years. The bookkeeper used straight line depreciation for 2018, 2019, and 2020, but failed to deduct the salvage value in computing the depreciation base. Let's take a look at this one. So for 2018 and 2019, those adjustments would be showing as a prior period adjustment in our statement of retained earnings. Remember that when we're showing our income for the current year, we're focused on the current year. So although we cannot fix 2018 and 2019 on this income statement, we can fix 2020. So the formula that what the bookkeeper did, they took 54,000. So again, with depreciation expense, acquisition costs, less the salvage value divided by the estimated useful life. So my acquisition cost, what the bookkeeper did is they took 54 minus zero salvage value divided by a estimated useful life of 6 years. So this is gonna be 54,000 divided by six or 9,000. So that's what the bookkeeper did. What should have the bookkeeper have done? Right, this should have been 54,000 acquisition cost minus the salvage value of nine divided by 6 years, or 45,000 divided by six, or 7,500. So I should have only taken 7,500, but I ended up taking 9,000. So I need to adjust this by the difference or 1,500. And this will be, I'm gonna do this as an add back. Because remember, this has a $9,000 adjustment. To make it correct, I have to add back 1,500. Okay. Number three, sale of securities, other income and expense. Four, when its president died, the corporation realized $150,000 from an insurance policy. The cash surrender value of the policy had been carried on the books as an investment in the amount of $46,000. The gain is non-taxable. So with this one here, I'm gonna highlight this. And the reason why is because I have to remember that when I'm going through and computing income tax expense a little bit later, that I want to make sure that I do not include this for purposes of determining my income tax expense. But what's going to be the gain on this? So the proceeds. So my proceeds from the policy, $150,000. Cash surrender value, $46,000. Gain on the policy is going to be here, $104,000. Now, what's really important here is I'm going to include this gain here in my coming up with a corrected continuing operations before income tax. Again, this would be an other income or expense. So, but I want to include this here in the gain, but when I come to determining my income tax expense, I'm going to go ahead and separate that out. So you look at number five. The corporation disposed of its recreational division at a loss of $115,000 before taxes. Assume that this transaction meets the criteria for discontinued operations. So since this is a discontinued operations, I'm going to show this below my continuing operations. So I don't have to really worry about that. Take a look at number six. The corporation decided to change its inventory method from pricing from average cost to FIFO. The effect of this change on its years is to increase 2018 income by $60,000 and decrease 2019 income by $20,000 before taxes. The FIFO method has been used for 2020. Tax rate on these items is 30%. This is going to be a prior period adjustment to retain earnings. So let's now that we look at this now, so let's go ahead and so my continuing or my net income, should I say income from continuing operations, including these adjustments. So I got 790. So I've got 862,500. Okay. So that is going to be just give me a moment. Make sure that I'm going through, I'm doing this right. So I get 790. I have an uninsured flood loss here for 90,000. A gain on a life insurance policy. Let's just make sure I'm adding these up correctly. This is 790 plus 57 plus 104 less 90,000 from the uninsured flood loss plus 1500. And I'm getting 862,500. I'm just gonna pause real briefly to see why I'm getting that mistake. So my mistake is number three. This should be a loss on the sale of securities. I always make this, I can oftentimes make mistakes too. So that's gonna be 57,000. So my income from continuing operations is gonna be 748,500. So again, I made a mistake. This number three, I was showing this as a plus. It should have actually been a minus. So this is my loss on sale of securities. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna figure out is my income tax expense. So I don't wanna just take this number and multiply it by that amount. And the reason why is because part of the income I have here is not taxable. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take 790 less 90 plus 1500 plus 57. Those would be my taxable income. If I multiply this through by 30%, I'm gonna get $193,350. So my net income from continuing operations is going to be $555,150. Okay. So we've got that part done. Now I have to deal with my discontinued operations. So for number five, so over here, less basically disposal. Okay, so I need to show this amount net of tax. Why am I showing it net of tax? Because I'm comparing it to a number that already has the taxes taken out. So my loss, my disposal, pre-tax was 115,000. My tax rate, so my taxes on this disposal, 34,500. So right over here, my disposal net of tax is going to be 115 minus 34, or 80,500. Okay, and we'll just put this in here right here. This is going to be, okay. So my net income is going to be 555,150 minus 80,500. Okay. So now what I need to do is I need to put my earnings per share. Okay, so there were no preferred dividends that I can see. So what I'm going to be doing right here is my basic earnings per share. And what's the difference between basic and fully diluted? You're going to be studying this in 202B or the second semester of intermediate accounting. There's basic and there's diluted. What does diluted mean? Diluted means I'm taking all common stock and common stock equivalents, as long as they are anti-dilutive, and figuring out what my earnings per share is. So if I have a lot of stock options that haven't been exercised, if I have bonds that are convertible into common stock, those are items I'm going to take into consideration for that. But over here, my basic earnings per share is going to be my net income minus my preferred dividends, dividing this by my weighted average shares outstanding. Okay. So for this one right here, and remember with discontinued operations, right, really important. This is going back here to CBIZ. Basic, continuing operations, discontinued operations, right? And that gets us down to our net income. So we can kind of do it the same way over here. So we'll have continuing operations, and this is going to be 555,150 divided by my weighted average shares outstanding, or 120,000. Okay. Okay, so let's bank this here. Okay. So my earnings per share, basic, could look something like this. Okay, so gone through over here. So this is problem 4-3. I want to thank you here for joining me here today, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great one.